Hey guys! Today I will show you how to draw these glowing mushrooms in the forest, step by step. I've created a mini set of brushes specially for this tutorial, which you can download along with a color palette for free in the video description below. If you like my videos, you can support me and unlock even more tutorials and brush sets by joining me on Patreon. The link is also below the video. Now let's grab our pencils and get started. I have a canvas that is 2000 by 2500 pixels, 300 dpi. Let's go ahead and change the background color. I'll tap here and view colors in cards. Then select background color right from here. Open the color palette again and pick grass. Now let's go to the brush set and select flakes brush. We will use it to draw the grass at the bottom. Let's set the size to 20% and draw an arc like this. I will continue painting below the arc without lifting the pencil up from the canvas. Now that we have the base color, let's continue applying it, but this time go lower. I will do it until the color gets completely dark at the lower edge. Just a couple more strokes and it is ready. We can draw the mushroom, and for that we need to create a layer above the hill. I want to start with a cap, so let's pick the color for it. For drawing I want to use ink bleed brush from Inkin. But before we start making the strokes, let's go to the settings and then to stabilization. Here I will increase the amount of streamline and also amount of stabilization, so we get smooth lines. Let's click done and pick the brush size. I don't want to make the edge too textured, so I think around 7% will work. Let's first create the outlines, and I will make the cap with a small angle to the ground. Start with an arc. And then continue drawing on top of it. Making the first curve, and I think on the right I will make it a little more curvy. Here I will press more to get thicker lines. Let's connect them. And after that, try to drag the color on this part. Adjust the color drop threshold. This part of the cap is ready. Let's now create a layer below this one and select the color that is called Jill. Now let's go back to the previous brush set and select Shiny Texture. Let's set the size to around 34% and start painting this empty area. I will make strokes to the sides. Let's try to be careful here. Lower the size so we don't go outside. This is also done. Let's draw the stem. And for the stem I will create a layer above all layers. There is also color called stem. Let's select it. I will go to recent brushes and pick ink bleed. Let's also outline it first, and this time I will make it more curvy on the left. Drawing a curve like this, then a line on top, and on the right it'll go as an arc. Let's connect these two curves at the bottom. And then fill the shape. Now that we have all the shapes, we can shade them. So I will go to the layer with the cap, create another one above it, and then clip. Here we have a few colors for shading. Let's start with this cap and stem shading number 2. First, I will be using fat nozzle brush from Spray Paints. Let's select it and set the size to around 11%. I will start drawing at the lower edge, shading it slightly. Then I will select Gel Thick Stripes and apply it a little on the left, also at the lower edge. Now let's select cap shading number 3. Apply it here and on these lines. Now let's pick this dark color that is cap shading 1 and draw here on the right. Now I will select this fat nozzle texture and draw here on the top left part. Now that we have this first shading, let's create one more layer and clip it too. Let's also set the layers mode to add. Go to the color palette and select cap texture. Then go to recent brushes and pick shiny texture from here. Let's set the size to around 30% and start making horizontal strokes without putting too much pressure. We will get this texture, but if we draw again, it'll get white. We can add this color on the highlight. I will go along the edge, like this, then a little down, and it will start to shine already. Let's work a little more on the left edge, make a couple strokes with very low pressure. And now it is ready. Let's continue working on this dark part. We can merge these three layers. Then go to the layer number 3. Create a layer above it. And also clip it. Let's start with Gel Thin Stripes. I will be using the same brush. Just make the size smaller. I think around 8 or 9%. And first add the stripes on the gel. And make them wider, close to the cap. Draw in the second one. Here I will draw a bigger arc and also widen it close to this edge. From here I will draw a line and widen it as well, making a few strokes. Another shorter line. And the last one here. Now let's work on the opposite side. First, I will draw a big arc that'll go like this. This brush is very pressure sensitive, so when we press more, it will get wider. And the color will get more opaque. Then I will draw a line the same way. And the last one. Make a few strokes here as well. Now let's grab a razor and set it to soft brush from airbrushing. We can set it to around 6% and go all over the edge slightly to create a shadow. Let's lower the size and also erase them around the stem. Now that we have the stripes, let's create a layer below. Change the color into thick stripes. Continue using shiny texture, but increase the size a little. I think we can set it to around 13%. And make the strokes between thin stripes. In the center, I'll make a few strokes here, then in this part, and go to the opposite side as well. The last area. And I think here we don't have to use a razor, because it is not touching the edges anyway. Let's now create one more layer, but this time above these two layers. Let's grab this yellowish color for the Jill lights. In the brushes I will go to airbrushing and pick medium hard airbrush. Let's set the size to 7%. And draw circles on these parts. They can be different size and opacity. We can even draw a couple of them. The last one. Then I will go to adjustments and apply Gaussian blur, just a little bit, around 2 or 3%. Now let's change this layer's blending mode to add. And they will shine. Let's consider this part of the mushroom ready as well and go to the stem. Here I will create a layer above it and also clip so the strokes stay within the shape. Let's select this pinkish color that is called cap and stem shading number 2. Select shiny texture and increase the size. I think here we can use it at around 30%. I will start making strokes carefully on top of the stem. Go a little down with vertical strokes. Now let's select stem shading color and apply it here on top. Go more to the sides. Not pressing too much, so we get the texture. Alright, now let's continue and select cap shading. Number 3. I will continue making the strokes down. Like this. Blending these colors. We can also try to apply this background mushroom shading on this part. It's a very nice blue color. Now let's pick background color and apply it here on the lower part of the stem to make it dark. I'm trying to keep the texture, so I'm not pressing too much. Let's also add it on the left side, following the shape with an angle and blending all the colors together. I will make it even darker at the bottom. And now to separate it from the background, we also need to add reflected light. Let's use this bluish color, that is called fat nozzle texture. I will draw on the right side slightly, so the mushroom also gets the volume. You can draw slightly on the left side. And also here in the middle. Just make a couple of strokes up and down. Alright, I think the mushroom is ready. We can merge all the layers for it. Now I want to blend it with the grass, and for that I will do the following. Let's tap on the layer and add a mask to it. It will get white. And we have black color selected. Now let's go to brushes and pick flakes brush that we used for the grass. We can just lower the size to around 12% and make a few strokes at the lower part of the stem. So it looks like the mushroom is inside the grass. This way we didn't damage the mushroom and we can always remove the mask. Now if everything is fine, we can merge these two layers. Let's duplicate it. Then scale one of the mushrooms. Rotate it. And move to the side. I will place them like this. And we can continue working on the background. I will select color that is called trees. Use shiny texture brush. But increase the size. I think here we can set it to around 44 or 45%. Let's also create a layer below this hill, right above the background color. I will start from the left side and make the strokes like this. Go down, make another curve, and then one more. Let's paint the area here. We are trying to create this atmosphere of the enchanted forest. Let me go a little to the right on top. And now let's draw on the left side. Here I will also first make an arc. It may go slightly curvy. Then down. And I will make a couple of curves. This way. Let's paint it here quickly. You can make the size even bigger to make it faster. I'm just drawing by lifting the pencil up and making strokes so the color gets darker and textured. Alright. Now let's change the color to tree shading number 1. And I think we can alpha lock the layer so the strokes stay inside. I will start drawing slightly here on the side. Let's paint on this area, but keep some gaps. Now I will work on this edge. Also go down. Make a few strokes in the middle. They may go as curves. Let's work on this edge and paint it this way. Now let's grab the next color that is lighter. Make the size a little lower and start making the strokes in the same manner. I will highlight the edge, go down here. Let's create this volume, highlight the edge, and try to keep the texture. Just making random strokes on the shape. Alright, I think it may be enough here. Let's go to the opposite tree and also add highlights on it. I will work on the edge more. Then draw here. And on the side. Now let's create a layer above this one. Then clip it. And pick fat nozzle texture color. And brush with the same name. We can set the size to 20% and just make a couple of strokes close to the edge to highlight it even more. The trees will be slightly exposed to this light from the mushrooms, so we need to consider that. Okay, I think this is also done. We can merge these two layers, create another one and drag it below. Let's first select the tree's color, go back to shiny texture, and draw a few more trees on the background. They may go as arcs with an angle. I will draw a tree here. And two thinner ones. Now let's select color that is called tree's shading number 2. Make a few strokes on these trees, on inner sides. After that, select color that is called fat nozzle texture, make the size smaller, and then add a few strokes like this. Now I will change the brush to fat nozzle brush, increase the size and paint on top of the canvas. Now let's go and change this layer's mode to overlay. Now let's create another layer and place it below all layers. I will select soft brush and just start drawing behind the mushrooms. Just a little bit, like this. Now let's merge these two layers for the mushrooms. Duplicate them. Alpha lock the layer that is below. And fill it with the current color. Then unlock it. And apply Gaussian blur. Let's set it to around 20%. And we can also try to change the layer's blending mode. It can be color dodge or add. Let's now create a layer above this one with these trees. Go to the color disk and pick pure white color. Then select stars brush from the set. Make the size around 36% and draw stars on the sky. Now let's blur them just a little bit, around 2%, and set the layer's mode to add. We can try to add a few bigger stars on the same layer. I will just change the color to background mushroom. Select this dotted brush and tap on the background with different brush sizes. Just a few. Let's also select Big Star, create another layer, but we can keep using the same color. I will be also changing the size and tapping on the canvas. Let me try to select Gel Lights and tap a few more times. I think I will blur them slightly, at around 2% as well. And here we can try to change the blending mode to Screen, Color Dodge or Add. I will keep it in Add. We will go back to mushrooms later, and now I'd like to draw mushrooms on the background. So I will create a layer above the current one and select background mushroom color. So I'm going to Selection and picking freehand without color fill to get the transparency effect. Let's first outline the cap. I will start from the left side and make a curve like this. Go to the right. Now let's draw an arc at the bottom. Close the shape by tapping here. Then go to Brushes and select Fat Nozzle. Here we can set the size to 6% and start painting inside. I will apply more color on top of the cap. Tap on the left side and make a subtle stroke on the right. Let's lower the size and apply the color at the lower edge, like this. Now I will change the brush to Ink Bleed. Still have the selection on. Let's set the size to 7% and make a few strokes this way, following the shape of the cap. We can also draw at the lower edge to make it more opaque. Now let's remove the selection and create a layer below this one. Let's continue using the ink bleed brush and connect the cap at the bottom. Also draw a few lines here inside. They will change the angle here. Let me actually make this edge a little more smooth using medium hard airbrush as an eraser. All right, now it's much better. Let's create a layer above layer number 10, which is this one, and select the color that is called background mushroom shading. Then I will grab Fat Nozzle and make a few strokes here inside, simply by tapping. Now let's draw the stem. For that I will create a layer above this one. Tap and hold to go back to the previous color and also change the brush to shiny texture. Let's find the suitable brush size that will be equal to the thickness of the stem. I think it can be set to 5%. I will just draw a curve like this. Make the color more opaque on top Then go to eraser and set it to the same brush with shiny texture. Just lower the size to 2% and start erasing it in the middle. Keeping more color at the bottom and on top. I think it is fine. We just need to go back to this layer and erase this line inside the stem. This mushroom is ready. Let me see if some adjustments are required. I will merge these layers. Maybe scale it a little. And rotate clockwise. Let me now duplicate this mushroom. Make this one smaller. And also rotate it. Let's merge them too. Duplicate again. Go to the layer below and blur it. Let's set the Gaussian blur to 7%. Then also change the layer's mode to add. If this glow is subtle, we can duplicate it a few times. Maybe once will be enough. Now I will group these three layers. Duplicate the group. And drag these mushrooms to the right. Flip them horizontal and also replace the group in the layers. It'll go upper. I'm placing it right behind the heel. I will make it bigger because it is closer to us. Change the angle and place these mushrooms on the side, like this. Now we can also add foreground plants. For that I'll create a layer above all layers. Select the color for foreground plants here from the palette. And pick one of the stems. Let's select plant silhouette number 1. I will set the size to 33% and tap on the canvas. Then move this plant to the right. Rotate it slightly. And adjust the size. Now let's create another layer and another brush with the second stem. I will set here the size to 34%. Tap again. Move it a little to the left. And also apply warp. I will drag it a little to the left here. So the flower is slightly bent. Now we can merge these two layers. Alpha lock them. To apply subtle shading, let's select this foreground plant shading color. And shiny texture. Let's set the size to around 28%. And just make a few strokes on some of the petals. Here. And maybe slightly on this. Alright, this is also done. Finally, we can create the glow. Let's first go to the layer with the grass and create a layer above it. Clip it and set it to overlay. I will grab pure white color from the disk. And soft brush from airbrushing. Let's set the size to 28% and highlight the edge to make it glow. After that, I will create a layer above the mushrooms, continue using white color, and select stars. Let's set the size to around 21% and draw these particles on the mushroom. Let's set it to add mode and blur using Gaussian blur. Since they're small, around 1% is fine. Now I will create one more layer. Go to the color palette and select color that is called light. Now let's select shiny texture. Set the size to around 20% and start making the strokes like this. You can make the size big enough. Draw these rays. Go into different sides. All right. I think this is enough. Let's set it to add mode and blur. I will set the Gaussian blur amount to 10%. Let's also lower the opacity of the layer a little. I think around 74%. Then I will go to the smudge tool and set it to soft brush. Let's set the size to 3% and start making the strokes in different directions. Mostly like this. You can change the size of the brush to make these rays thinner. Let me grab a razor, set it to the same brush and erase it slightly here on the gel. Now the drawing is almost ready, but in the end I always like to adjust the colors. Most of the time I do it using Adobe Lightroom, but something can be done in Procreate as well. Let's now go to the top layer, then to Actions, Add, and copy canvas. Open it again and paste. Now we will get all the layers merged. What we can do is fix the contrast by using curves. I will drag this corner inwards and this one to the right. Also, we can try to sharpen it using Sharpen tool from Adjustments. The textures will become more clear. I don't want to overdo it. Around 17% is fine. Also, there is a way to change the hue. You can play around here. Or play with color balance. Here you can add more cyan or magenta and switch between yellow and blue. I will keep original colors and I will be looking forward to seeing your versions. If you enjoyed this tutorial, please give it a like and don't forget to subscribe. You can also access more tutorials and brush sets on my Patreon. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.